To summarize Leviticus in one sentence, we could say, it is the Lord's devices. Can you guess what this means? Frame of the Old Testament. Please follow the sequence from ages, leaders, key places, national perspective, authorities' perspective, to the genealogy of Jesus, then the book's allocation, and their representative triplets, and the spiritual perspective of prophets. Lastly, the chronicles of BC and Adam. Please open the book of Exodus, chapter 12, verse 14. Now the length of time the Israelite people lived in Egypt was 430 years. Since the entering into Egypt was in 2238 of the Adam Chronicle, the year they came out of Egypt was 2668. Fifth implication. Before we start, I have a question for you. Whose festivals were they? Were they the Israelites? No, they were the Lord's festivals, as stated in chapter 23, verse 4. These are the Lord's appointed feasts. In order to understand the appointed festivals, you need to first look at the fruits and grains which were available at the time in Israel. What were seven major plants to harvest in Israel at the time? Five fruits and two grains were available over seasons, as stated in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 8. A land with wheat and barley, vines and fig trees, pomegranates, olive oil, and honey. The first fruits were from fig trees in the beginning of the first month of the year and were followed by barley in the same month. Wheat was harvested in the third month and followed by vines in the next month. On the fifth month, pomegranates were harvested and the olives and honey, the trees, followed respectively in the sixth and seventh months. First, bargain. Just before the Passover, fig trees were in their first fruit, which were called bargain. This was for travelers. After this bargain, fig trees were four times more in fruit, which were tiani. The bargain was often quoted in Psalms or other books to represent great love or an earnest wish, because it was the first fruit after long winter season during which the Israelites could not taste any sweetness. The Passover was on the 14th day of the first month in the Jewish calendar. Hereafter we denote it as 1/14, and I call it January 14th. Actually, this is not today's January. That is, in Jewish calendar, the first month, I call it January in this class. On the 15th day of that month, the Lord's Feast of the Unleavened Bread began for 7 days, as stated in chapter 23, verse 6. Second, barley. Barley ripened around the Passover on the first month of the Jewish calendar, which was the equivalent to April. A sheaf of the first grain of barley was offered on the next day of the first Sabbath after the Passover in chapter 23, verse 10. It was the feast of first fruits. The third, wheat. Wheat ripened around 7 weeks after the Passover on the third month. And the Israelites offered a sheaf of the first wheat on the day after the seventh Sabbath, which was called as the wheat harvest or just the harvest, and many times it was called as the Feast of Weeks. It was sometimes also called the Pentecost as well. It is a little difficult to distinguish the first fruits, the harvest, the weeks, and the Pentecost. Let me differentiate them one by one. The first fruits was the first grain of the year, not of each plant. So this was only for barley because its harvest time was earlier, near the Passover, than wheat as stated in Exodus chapter 9, verse 31 to 32. Open the verse. The flax and barley were destroyed. Since the barley had headed and the flax was in bloom, the wheat and spelt, however, were not destroyed because they ripened later. This passage was about the seventh plague close to the Exodus or the Passover. So we are assured that barley's harvest was around the time of the Passover, which was much later. Hence, wheat couldn't be the offering of the first fruits. From the first Sabbath after the Passover to the seventh Sabbath were 7 weeks, 49 days. Hence, the day after of the seventh Sabbath was also the 49th day after the first Sabbath. That's why it was called the Feast of Weeks. Of course, this day was the 50th day from the first Sabbath, which was called the Pentecost. Notice that the Feast of Weeks was not on a single day, but 49 days, whereas the first fruits, the harvest, and the Pentecost were on a single day. This was a cause of the confusion because the first fruits was the beginning of the Feast of Weeks, and the harvest or the Pentecost was at the end of it. Therefore, the first fruits and the harvest or the Pentecost could be called as the Feast of Weeks, because they were the beginning and the end of it. But the first fruits and the harvest were not identical. This spring season represented Jesus' first coming, which was fulfilled 2,000 years ago. Why? Because it was presumed that Jesus died on January 14th, as stated in Mark chapter 14, verse 12, on the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Actually, this day was the Passover in Matthew chapter 26, verse 17. Jesus took the Last Supper on that day, and he died on the cross the next day. There are different opinions on the resurrection day around the 17th or 18th by varying the date of 14th as Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. It doesn't matter because the important thing is that he died before the Sabbath and resurrected on the day after the Sabbath. Here, for instance, let's assume that it was Friday. So the day after Sabbath was the 16th. Jesus resurrected on the day after the Sabbath. Jesus ascended on February 25th, 40 days after his resurrection. And Holy Spirit descended on March 4th, 50 days after the first Sabbath. If we assume that the day was Wednesday, the ascending and descending days would be February 27th or March 6th, respectively. From a spiritual point of view, the former days were most likely possible because the March 4th were presumed when the Lord descended on Mount Sinai to give the Ten Commandments to the Israelites, as stated in Exodus chapter 19, verse 11, and be ready the third day, because on that day the Lord will come down on Mount Sinai in the sight of all the people. And this seemed to be the last showcase of the Lord to convince the Israelites before entering the promised land, because they had to banish all the people inside it. Let's try to map the Lord's feast to these. The Passover was January 14th, as stated Exodus chapter 12, verse 6, and the unleavened bread was January 15th, as stated in Leviticus chapter 23, verse 6. Please open your Bible to the verse and another passage, Exodus chapter 12, verse 18. In the first month, you are to eat bread made without yeast from the evening of the 14th day until the evening of the 21st day. When was the unleavened bread according to this passage? It was from January 14th. 221st, which is correct, Leviticus chapter 23, verse 6, or Exodus chapter 12, verse 18. To find this answer, we need to look at the next passage, Exodus chapter 12, verse 19. For 7 days, no yeast is to be found in your houses. How many days? Yes, 7 days. Please count from 14th to 21st. How many days? Yes, it was 8 days. Why is this contradictory to the previous passage? Because the Israelites eight bread made without yeast, as stated in Exodus chapter 12, verse 8, on the Passover. Therefore, the verse Exodus chapter 12, verse 8, described the duration when the Israelites ate bread made without yeast, not of the unleavened bread. And the Israelites left Egypt on the first day of the unleavened bread, as stated in Exodus chapter 13, verse 4. Today, in the month of Abib, you are living. It was January 15th. Please count it. When was the 50th day after they left? At the time, 1 month was 30 days. So in the first month from 15th to 30th equals to 16 days. The second full month was 30 days. Then the total was 46 days. Hence, in the third month, fourth day, was the 50th day after the Exodus. This day was matching to the descriptions of Exodus chapter 19, verse 11. Be ready by the third day, because on that day the Lord will come down on Mount Sinai in the sight of all the people. Because it was assumed that Moses went up to Mount Sinai the next day. On March 2nd, after arriving at the Sinai desert, as stated in Exodus chapter 19, verse 1, in the third month after the Israelites left Egypt. In conclusion, the Israelites received the Ten Commandments on March 4th, the 50th day after leaving Egypt, and met the Lord in person on Mount Sinai. It was the origin of the Pentecost. Let's substitute this itinerary with Jesus' missionary on the cross. He took the Last Supper on January 14th and died on January 14th afternoon. He was buried in the tomb before sunset on January 14th, as stated in Mark chapter 15, verse 42 to 43. It was a preparation day, that is the day before the Sabbath. So as evening approached, Joseph of Arimathea, a prominent member of the council who was himself waiting for the kingdom of God, went boldly to Pilate and asked for Jesus' body. He died as an offering of the Passover's lamb for our sins. The 15th of the first month was the Sabbath. Then he was resurrected on the 16th after the Sabbath, as stated in Matthew chapter 28, verse 1. After the Sabbath at dawn, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. Then he was resurrected as the first fruit of the dead, as well as the Lord's glory. This was the first fruits. Then he ascended on 40th day after his resurrection, as stated in Acts chapter 1, verse 3. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. Then the Holy Spirit descended on the Pentecost, as stated in Acts chapter 2, verse 1. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. At the time, the Pentecost was March 4th because the first Sabbath after the Passover was the 15th. It was exactly the same day to the day that the Lord came down to the Mount Sinai to give the Ten Commandments. At this time, the Lord gave the people Holy Spirit instead of the laws. These feasts of the Passover, the first fruits, and the Pentecost anticipated Jesus' first coming. First vines. Only fruits of vines were used for, branches of it were used only for burning. The fifth, pomegranates. Pomegranates represented the priest. This may be an antitype of Jesus. The sixth, olive. There were four levels of olive oil which were made out of the odor of squeezing oil from olives. The oil from the first squeezing was used for lamps or anointing instruments in the tent. The second oil was used for anointing priests. The third one was for food, and the fourth one was for lambs at home and healing. The seventh, nut or honey. This was the last harvest in Israel on the seventh month. There were three God's feasts, such as the Feast of Trumpet, a Day of Atonement, and Ingathering. The trumpets could symbolize the trumpet in Revelation. The atonement represented greater tribulation in Revelation. The ingathering implied gathering God's people after judgment in Revelation, because the saved people are the fruits of Jesus' missionary. In other words, these three feasts represented Jesus' second coming. Like this, the feast implied Jesus' coming, as stated in the book of Colossians chapter 2, verse 16 to 17. The feasts were shadow of Jesus. Please remember this. The feasts were shadow of Jesus. Thank you for watching.